so I've been kind of quiet for a while. This is mainly due to one reason. As you can see from all the junk everywhere around here, I've been doing some home renovation projects. I am, however, almost finished with all of that. So in a really short time, I'm hoping to be able to get back to our regular programming. And you can also expect to see some shop update projects or shop renovation projects. As you can see, my garage is in a complete disarray because of this. There are junk and crap and sawdust everywhere. But I am planning to have it back in order shortly. And you can expect to see some shop update projects. The main reason I'm doing this film, the main reason I'm doing this video or shooting this film, is because I wanted to try out my new lapel mic. It's a Rode SmartLav Plus, and like, my initial tests are really positive. So I'm hoping to have better audio in my coming videos. And just so you know, this entire episode won't be of me cleaning. I do have a small project I want to make. And right now I can't find my carpet knife. And I'm back. This TIG torch is okay, but kind of big. And I could put on a stubby gas lens kit, which I have for it. But it still has one main disadvantage. This neck here is not flexible. However, this one is. And having both a flexible neck and a stubby gas lens kit would make this TIG torch 1,000 times more pleasant to use. Like, it's strictly not necessary, but it's a lot more pleasant. If I can get this one apart. I have had it apart before, like 6 years ago. Because originally, this TIG torch actually had this neck here. One thing I think I did when I put this in place, I'm not really sure if it was this one or another one, I actually wrapped some duct tape around this part because the diameter didn't match up. It's probably gotten all gummy from being hot when I welded with it as well. And now the question is, should I break it or not? I mean, I have an extra. This one, and I'm guessing that the quality is about the same. I didn't really plan on this taking this much force to get apart, I must admit. It's moving! At least somewhere it's moving. Ah, come on! Yeah, there it goes. Okay, it wasn't duct tape, it was electrician's tape. Probably worse, to be honest. So let's get all this gunk off. There we go. One wrench. Let's see if this one fits. It might actually work. Yeah, it works. Yeah, I'm replacing that one as well. And nope, not that way around. That way around. Oh yeah, right. I should probably put something around that brake as well. Let me see what I can come up with. This might work. It's shrink hose with the glue on the inside, but it might be, yeah, too small. 1 second. Okay, this one will work. Unfortunately, it doesn't have any glue on the inside, but it should still be fine. This is a WP26, and it's a bit crooked because it's old. And this is WP26F. The F stands for flexible, of course. This is a really big shrink tube. So let's see if I can find that Stubby Gansler's kit I was talking about. I think it's somewhere over here. I think I should have another Teflon insulator here somewhere. I think this one will work better. Yeah, that should work a lot better. So, just as a comparison, here's the size difference. I mean, the big one doesn't even fit in screen right now. So this one is a lot handier and easier to use. So now I only need to put a couple of welding videos together. No biggie. Thanks for watching.